Let's explore iteration burndown chart. Whenever we are discussing any line chart, we should be very clear about what is there in the x-axis and what is there in the y-axis. So when we are focusing on iteration burndown chart, the x-axis represent time. In case of iteration, it's a days. At the end of a day one, day two, day three, day four, I am assuming 10 days in an iteration. So that's why the x-axis is having days. The y-axis is important. It is about remaining work. Be very clear, the work which is remaining is represented in the y-axis. So when I'm starting from the day zero, the top line is starting from the total work in an iteration. When I go to day one, I am thinking, oh, what is left after day one is over, after day two is over, after day three is over, and similarly, it will go further. Now, the question may come, how do we quantify remaining work? How do we measure it? Usually, you see the story points are used. Yeah. In an iteration burndown chart, sometimes you can also use estimated hours, which is pretty popular. Sometimes you may just want to count number of tasks. So remaining work, you need to quantify remaining work. And the quantification might be done in the format of effort hours or in the format of story points, or by using number of tasks. Now here you see a blue color line, which is like a forecasted line or expected line. Sometimes you call it predicted line. So we are assuming that this is how we will go, and at the end we will finish the iteration. The red line where I am showing is something which is an actual line. Yeah. Now you also see there is a point A where the red line or an actual line is above the forecasted line. Now, this is an important language for your PMP exam. When the red line in a burndown chart or your actual line in your burndown chart is above the forecasted line, it means you are going slow. You have a more work left because your remaining work is more. So you have a more work left to finish. At the point B, I'm showing the reverse situation where my actual line is below the forecasted or expected line. At the point B, means at the end of a day three, we seems to be doing faster than initially estimated because our red line is below the expected or forecasted line. If you keep these two things in mind, you are good for your iteration burndown chart for PMP exam.